1,197 men were on the ship. 317 survived. About 900 were laid in the water. I was signing aboard the USS Indianapolis, roughly the first, I can't tell you guys, first week in May. And they sent me to a 20-millimeter school, Mark 14 sight school, firefighting school. Anyhow, when the ship got out of Maryland, out of dry dock, we went down to Hunters Point, San Francisco. From there we got supplies, and there we loaded the first atomic bomb aboard the ship. At 10 after 12 Sunday night, so the commander said the submarine, he shot six torpedoes. Two of them hit. One blew about 30, 40, 50, I can't tell you exactly the footage, off the bow. The other one hit midship, which is the aviation gasoline was stored in that area, and 8-inch powder for the 8-inch gun was stored in that area. That blew a big hole in the bottom of the ship. The ship was 610 feet long and it sank in 12 minutes, which is very, very fast, that length of ship. And when I was sleeping topside up on the bow, toward the bow, because it was too hot below deck. And when the torpedoes hit, I went up, I don't know how many feet, and I moved over about 12, 15 feet. And when I picked myself up on a cable that was outside the ship, then I went aft, because that was my GQ, general quarters. And you couldn't get across the quarter deck because it was engulfed in flames. So me and, I don't know, 15, 20 others went forward. By that time, we could see the ship was going to sink and was listening quite a bit to the starboard side. So myself and three, four other guys, we tossed off the life raft that was tied to the 8-inch gun turret. We cut them, three of them down. We threw them overboard. By that time, none of us had life jackets. Behind the 8-inch guns had a big canvas bag with life jackets in them. So we cut them down and started dishing them out. By that time, the ship was really slipping to the starboard side. I got the jacket on no more than a minute or two, and the ship made a plunge. Anyhow, the bow was underwater. And a lot of people asked me, so where were you on the ship when you jumped off the ship? I didn't jump off the ship. The ship left me. There was no more ship on it, so I swam away. And I swam probably over 30, 40 yards, and the ship would just bounce up and down like a bobber in the water. The bow went down first, of course. And there wasn't much. A lot of people asked me about the suction after it goes down. There's very little of that because of the way it went down. I bounced up and down four, five, six times, and the last, oh, say 200 feet or whatever, just went down real slow. There was no suction. Because I talked to men that was real close to the ship and there wasn't anything. Anyhow, this happened 10 after 12 Sunday night. And you couldn't tell how many in the group till Monday morning got daylight. And I was probably a group of 75, 80 people. It's hard to determine how many in the group because we were 12, 10 to 12 foot sway, about high as this room, swells. So you're either going up or coming down, so you couldn't tell really how many in your group. But we was in diesel fuel, we got saturated with that. Then by the swell, little diesel fuel in your mouth and the odor and the salt water and the blowing up of the ship and bouncing up and down, a combination of three, four things, you threw up not everything out of your stomach, but you threw up some. And we went 4 days and five nights in the Cape Cod life jacket without food and water. Wednesday afternoon, just before dark, I was a group of probably 18, 20, and narrowed down to that. And I forgot who, I don't know who he was. And he says, they're looking for us all day Tuesday and all day Wednesday. They're not looking for us. So we just made up our mind, hell, this is where we're going to die. Well, about 11 o'clock Thursday morning, that's when the plane spotted us. Well, we try to keep each other alive by encouraging, but we're all in the same condition. We're all, hungry, thirsty, out of our heads. In other words, there wasn't much difference between any one of us. I've had a lot of doctors tell me you can't live on for that long. But we did. My dad signed me to go to the Navy at 17. I come home from boot camp. I was leaving down to the railroad station. He shook my hand real firmly, real serious look in his eyes. This is April 45. I want you to come home, Dick. I said, well, Dad, the war's putting over in Europe. In fact, it was practically over in Europe. Nothing's going to happen. Don't worry about it. Well, every time I was ready to give up, there was my dad's face. So he brought me home. And I told him when I got home, too. He really brought me home. I'm Dick Thelen from Lansing, Michigan. I was a survivor of the USS Indianapolis. I'm proud to be a survivor, and I'm never unhappy that I went in the Navy to serve my country.